Abby and Ben did household chores last weekend. Together they earned $50. Let me underline that. Together they earned $50, and Abby earned $10 more than Ben. Let me underline that as well. Abby earned $10 more than Ben. How much did each earn? Now we could just go and solve it, but it looks like they want to ask something else. If you were to use the graph above, which strategy is most useful in helping you find the answer to the problem? So we don't even have to solve for it. They just want us to tell them what is the best strategy for solving the problem. So the first choice, they say finding an equation for the blue line. So let's look at this graph that they've also given us. So the blue line here is the graph that using the information that Abby earned $10 more than Ben. That's what that says. It's written a little bit small, but hopefully you can see it. Abby earned $10 more than Ben, which is this information over here. And so if you call this over here the b-axis for the amount Ben earned, and this is the a-axis for the amount Abby earned, the equation of this line would be Abby is equal to, the amount Abby earned is going to be $10 more than the amount Ben earned. So that's the equation of that line right there. Well, that by itself isn't going to help you figure out how much did each earn. So that by itself won't solve the problem. Finding the red line's y-intercept. So let's look at the red line. The red line is using the information that Abby and Ben earned $50 combined. It's this information up here. And the equation of that would be Abby's earnings plus Ben's earnings are equal to $50. If you were to just find the y-intercept there, it's just at 50. That's really not giving you any information in figuring out how much did they each earn and actually solving for a and b. So b by itself won't work. Finding the line's point of intersection. Now that's interesting, because the point of intersection gives you, so let me circle that a little bit bolder. Let me do it in orange and a magenta color. So the point of intersection right there, that gives us an a and b value that will satisfy both equations. And if you're satisfying both equations, it'll satisfy both constraints. So if we just eyeball it off this chart, it looks like b is equal to 20 and a is equal to 30. And if we just use these numbers relative to this, together they earned $50. That works. If Abby earns 30 and Ben earns 20, they'll earn $50. And 30 is $10 more than 20. So this worked. By looking at the point of intersection, we're able to figure out how much Abby and Ben earned. So I would go with C. We don't even have to read D, but they say you cannot tell how much they earned because there are two lines on the graph. No, that's complete silliness right there. So the choice is C.